Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about the belt rope end change. Okay, so I think you all of you are aware with the three words that is called as a belt, another is a rope, and another is a chain. Okay, so this belt or rope or chain is the nothing more than, but that is called as used to transmit the power from the one shaft to the another shaft by means of pulley. Okay, so which rotate at the same speed or different speed. So it is doesn't mean, but it is the concern with what, whenever we transmit the transmit the power from one pulley to the another pulley, that time we generally use the belts and ropes. Okay, so the amount of power transmitted depend on the following factors. Whenever we transmitted the power from the one pulley to the another pulley, that time the depending factors is concerned with the velocity of the belt. Okay, so the tension under which belt is the place on the pulley, and the arc of contact between the belt and belt and the smaller pulley. Okay, so generally the belt rope end change is used for the generally used for the transmitting the power from the one pulley to another pulley. But most important criteria in the depending factor is the velocity of the belt. Okay, whenever you design the brakes, that time the velocity of the belt is most important, and according to the velocity, tension is concerned, and according to the tension, the arc of contact between the belt and smaller pulley is the very important criteria for this. And now another part is concerned with the types of belt drive. First of all, there is the three section in this chapter. First of all is the belt, second thing is the rope, and third one is the chain. Okay, so first of all we had discussed about the belt drive, then chain, then rope and chain drive. Okay, so generally what is the light drive? Whenever you design the belt, that time the light drive is used for what? The small power is transmitted up to the speed of the 10 meter per second. In agriculture machines and small machines tool, it will be used the drive, light drives. Okay, and up to the 10 meter per second to the 22 meter per second, that time we use the medium drives. Okay, and up to the above the 22 meter per second, that is called as a heavy drive. It will be used in the compressor and generator. So basically three types of drive according to the its speed. Okay, 10 meter per second, 10 meters per second to the 22 meter per second, and above 22 meter per second, it will be a light, medium, and heavy drive. Okay, so generally the belt drive is used in the agriculture, small machines tools also, and also in the compressor and generator. Okay, so that is the types of the belt drive. Another is the types of the belt. Okay, which types of belts are available in the market? The first of all is a flat belt. Okay, as shown in figure here, that is the concern with the flat. Okay, flat, that means what? It is the its surface of the belt is flat. As shown in figure, they mostly used in the workshop and moderate the amount of power is transmitted from the one pulley to the another pulley when two pulley are not more than 8 meter apart. Okay, so distance between the two pulleys 8 meter apart. Okay, not more than 8 meter apart. That time we can use the flat belt drive. Okay, but in a V belt drive, as shown in figure, mostly used in the factory and workshop where the moderate amount of the power is to be transmitted one pulley to the another pulley when two pulley are which near to each other. Okay, so it is the call as when the two pulleys each near to each other, that time not 8 mm apart, that time we can use the V belt. So this is the shape in the V, so that is called as a V belt. Another is a circular belt according to its shape, that is called as a circular. The circular belt or rope, as shown in figure, are mostly used in the factory and workshop where the great amount of the power is transmitted from one pulley to the another pulley when the pulley are more than 8 meter apart. Okay, so up to the now what we had studied, three types of belt. First of all is a flat belt in the 8 meters apart, that is called as a flat belt according to the shape. Okay, now another is the concern with the we built the two pulley is the distance between the two pulleys very close or very each other, okay, and in circular belt that is the parts of the more than 8 mm parts, okay. So that is the flat belt, circular flat belt, circular belt, and we belt according to the its applications. We can use these types of belt type, okay. Now which types of material used in the use for the belts? First of all is we know that that is called as a leather belt. Another is a cotton or fabric belts, okay. Another is a rubber belt. Another is called as a Baltas belt. Okay, so it will be a majority in a generally rubber belt and leather belt is used in the majority in a in a practice. We can see in the majority in industry leather belt and rubber belt. Okay, now what is the types of belt? First of all, is a open belt drive. Open belt drive. That means what? That is that we can see here the two pulley. Okay. So that is called as a driver pulley. Driver pulley means that means what you can drive. Okay, so that is called as a driver pulley. Another is a driven pulley. Driven pulley is driving by the this driver. Okay, so that is called as a driver pulley, and that is called as a driven pulley. Okay, in which belt will be a passing through the power will be transmitted from the one pulley to the another pulley. That time it will be a call as a slack side, and another call is a tight side. Okay, so that is the basic that is the call as of that universal for the tighting and sleezing purpose. Okay, so this is called as the open belt drive, in which one pulley to the one transmitted to the one pulley to the another pulley by using a power by using the belt. That is called as the open belt drive. Another is the another concern with the cross or twist belt. In the open belt drive, that is the open. Okay, no will be a no belt will be a not in the cross all or not will be in the closing for the driving and driven pulley. And cross belt drive, that means what? It will be a passing through this point to the this point by using the cross. Okay, cross will be a concern here, slack side, and another is a tight side. Okay, so first of all is a driver pulley, that is called as a driven pulley. And you can see here the front view and top view top view of this belt, that is called as a cross or twist belt drive. That is called as a slack side and tight side. That is called as a cross or twist belt. In this drive, the belt will be a twist. That is called as a also concerned with the twist and cross belt. Okay. Another is a quarter turn belt drive. Quarter turn belt drive. That means what? The pulley will be a driver pulley. Up to the now, what we had studied in the open belt drive. A driver pulley and driven pulley will be in the same axis. Okay, also cross belt drive, driver pulley and driven pulley will be also in the same axis. Okay, but in a quadrant turn belt drive, we can here see that here a belt will be a transmitted one pulley to another pulley, but it will be a not in the same axis. Driver pulley in this axis, driven pulley will be a this axis, and in which between the due to the tightening or slacking purpose, that is the guided pulley will be attached here. That is called as a quarter turn belt drive, and it is called as a quarter turn belt drive. Okay, and another is the belt drive with the ideal pulley. Ideal pulley, that means what? Tightening of the belt is not concerned. That is tightening is the most important concern in the belt drive, because the without tightening we cannot transmit the power from the one pulley to the another pulley. So belt drive with the ideal pulley, that means what? You can engage the ideal pulley between the driver and driven pulley in the driven pulley to the driven pulley. That is called as a ideal pulley. Okay, so that is called as a belt drive. Another is the compound belt drive. Compound belt drive, that means what? You can here see that is called as a driver pulley. This is called as a driven pulley. On the driven pulley, you can another pulley will be put here. That is called as a driver pulley, and another is a driven pulley. Okay, so in all the pulley in one axis, but on the driver pulley and driven pulley on the same axis on same shaft. Okay, so, in top view you can see here. So it is called as a driver pulley. This is called as a driven pulley. On this shaft, this is concerned with the driver pulley, and another parts is a driven pulley. Okay, that is called as a compound belt drive. Okay, and also that is called as a compound belt drive. And stepped or cone pulley drive. Stepped and cone pulley drive, that means what? The pulley will be a stepped. That is the according to the spill, we can change our stepped pulley. That is called as a driver pulley. This is called as a driven pulley. But according to the step, we can driving shaft to the driven shaft, we can use the stepped or cone pulley drive. Okay, so this is will be used in the driving purpose also. Now, another most important criteria we can see in belt and belt drive. Most important factors is depending in the fuel drive for the transmission power from the one pulley to the another pulley. That is called as a velocity ratio. According to the velocity ratio, you can suggest the belt. Also concerned with the, you can suggest the suggesting the belt designs. This is the concern with the velocity ratio of the belt drive. What is the velocity ratio? It is the ratio between the velocity of the driver and follower driven. Okay, how much driver pulley or driven pulley rotating in the shaft, that is called as a velocity ratio of the driving and to the driven pulley. It may be expressed in the mathematically. Suppose D1 is the driver pulley, of D2 is the diameter of the followers, diameter of the driver and diameter of the follower. That means follower, that means for driven. Okay, and that is N1 is equal to the speed of the driven pulley and N2 equal to speed of the followers. That is called as a driven. Now, the length of the belt that pass over the driver in 1 minute. Okay, so that is called as a pi D1 N1, and similarly length of the belt pass over the followers or driven, that is called as a pi D2 N2. Okay, so since the length of the belt pass over the driver in 1 minute is equal to length over the pass over the followers. Okay, so in 1 minute, how much length will be a passing in driver pulley to the driven pulley? It will be expressed by pi D1 N1 equal to pi D2 N2. That is called as a velocity ratio. Okay, in a simple manner, in a 1 minute, how much length will be passing to the one driver pulley to the driven pulley? That is called as a velocity ratio. Okay. In simply, this is the equations pi d1 n1 equal to pi d2 n2. So that is called as a velocity ratio of the belt. Another is the velocity ratio of the belt in another point will be expressed. This is pi will be deleted here. Okay. So n2 by n1 equal to d1 by d2. So that is the velocity ratio of the driver pulley to the driven pulley. Now, if we consider the thickness in the belt, okay, so if we consider the thickness in the belt, so N2 equal to D1 plus T and N1 equal to D2 plus T, that is the thickness of the belt, that is called as a velocity ratio of the belt. Okay, now another is the slip of the belt. Slip of the belt is the major drawbacks in the belt drive. Whenever we use the belt drive, that time the slipping of the belt is the most difficult part in the workshop as well as in the industry. That is called as a slip of the belt. What is the slip of the belt? We can here see in this figure, that is the driver pulley. Okay, in the driver pulley, that is the belt will be attached in the driver pulley. The load will be carrying on this belt, and it will be going to in the it will be as per the application, it will be passing through the belt. Okay, so that is called as the slip of belt. In which, what is the slip of belt? We had discussed the motion of the belt shaft, assuming the frame frictional grip between the belt and shaft. Okay, up to the now, what we had considered in the velocity ratio, the gripping between the belt and shaft is the frame frictions. But sometimes the friction grip become insufficient. Okay, so it may causes the forward motions of the driver without the carrying a belt. Whenever the belt will be driving to the driven shaft, it will be a forward without the carrying a belt. That is the simple, in a simple manner, that is called as a slip of the belt. Okay, so result of the belt slipping is to reduce the velocity ratio. So it will be a slipping of the belt is directly influence the velocity ratio. We know that we know that what is the equation for the velocity ratio, that is called as N2 by N1 equal to D1 by D2. So it will be carrying as that the slipping of the belt is common phenomena. Thus the belt should not never be used where the defender velocity ratio is important. In case of the hour, minutes or second arm is in the watch, so it will be a slipping of the belt. Okay, so if we are getting the more velocity ratio, you can solve and you can find out the what is the slip of the build in a practical manners. Okay, so in such a manners, what is the basic concept of the slipping of the build, you can find out by the, in such a case, that is called as a by the hours, minute and seconds armed in the watch. Okay, set this in how much minute it will be carrying without the carrying a build, that is the call as a slipping of the build. Okay, now another, what is the slipping of the build, how can we find out that? In, we know that percentage S1 is the slip of the build in the driver build, S2 is the slip between the follower and driven build. Okay, from these equations we can find out this equation if thickness of the build T is considered. Okay, we know that what is the velocity ratio, it is the N2 by N1 equal to D1 by D2, that is called as a velocity ratio. If we consider the thickness, that time N2 by N1 equal to D1 plus T and D2 plus T. Okay, but if we consider the slip of the build, that time the velocity ratio will be converted here, that is called as a N2 by N1 plus D1 plus T plus D2 plus T, 1 minus S by 100. Okay, but S, that means what? That is the percentage of slip of belt in the driver pulley, and S2 equal to slip of belt in the driven pulley. Okay, and both the summations of the driver pulley to the driven pulley, and it will be converted into the S, that is called as a slip of the belt. Okay, now another topics is up to the now what we had studies. First of all is the velocity ratio. Velocity ratio, that means what in the build, that is called as a N2 by N1 equal to D1 by D2. Okay, but if we consider the thickness, that time N2 by N1 equal to D1 plus T plus D2 plus T. But if we consider in this considerations, we cannot consider the slipping of the build. But if we consider the slipping of the build, that time it will be a N2 by N1, D1 plus T, D2 plus T, 1 minus S by 100, that is the equations for the slipping of the build. Now, another topic is concerned with the build, that is called as a creep of build. Creep of build, that means what? When the build is passing from the slack side to tight side, we know that what is the slack side and what is the tight side. Okay, so a creation portions of the build extend in contracts against the build passing from the tight side to slack side. Due to this change of the length, there is the relative motions between the belt and pulley surface. This relative motions is the term as a creep. Okay, so if the belt is passing to the slack side to tight side, that time the changing in the length will be occur. Okay, changing in the length will be occur. That is called as a creep of belt. Okay, up to the now we know that what is the velocity ratio. It is the concern with the N2 by N1 equal to D1 by D2. So we can add here the Young modulus of material, E plus under root sigma 2, E plus under root sigma 1, and S1 and S2 is a stress in the belt of the tight side and slack side respectively. That is called as a Young modulus of material of the belt. Okay, so that is called as a creep of belt. Here we can see here the one examples. The power is transmitted from a pulley 1 meter diameter running at 200 rpm to a pulley 2.5 meter diameter by means of the belt. Find the speed lost by the driving pulley as a result creep if the stress on the tight side and slack side of the belt 1.4 megapascals and 0.5 respectively. The Young modulus of material is the belt is 100 megapascal. In this example, D1 is the 1 meter, that is called as a driver pulley diameter. N1 is concerned with the 200 rpm, that is called as a driver pulley rotations. D2 is a 2.5 meter here, and we can find out the N2. Okay, so that is called as a how much N2 driven pulley will be rotated in the directions. Okay, so in rotating in the RPM, so sigma 1 is equal to 1.4 megapascal. It will be like 1.4 into 6 into 10 raised to 6, that is called as a Newton per mm square. And also sigma 2 is equal to 0.5 megapascals. Okay, and Young modulus of elasticity is given here, 100 megapascal. So we know that the neglecting the creep, n2 by n1, that is called as a, from this equation n2 by n1 equal to d1 by d2. So without the creeping here, the 88.9 rpm we get it, okay? And the considering the creep, we know that what is the creep, it will be a changing in the length whenever the bale will be passing through the slack side to the tight side and tight side to slack side. It will be a depend in the drum rotations, okay? So in this regard, n2 by n1 equal to d1 by d2, that is called as the E Young modulus of elasticity. And without creeping, 88.9, but we know that by using the creeping, because the stress will be a concern, Young modulus will be a concern. So in this case, that is called 88.7. So what is the difference? What is the speed of the driven pulley due to the creep? That is 0.02 RPM. Okay. So in a simple manner, 0.2 RPM will be a reducing by using the creep. So this is the example for the power transmission in the pulley. Okay. So another is the power transmission by the belt. Power transmission by the belt, that means what? How much power will be transmitted from the one pulley to the another pulley? That is the concern with the power transmission by the belt. Okay. We know that if your drum will be rotated in the distal direction, that is called as a slack side. Okay. And this is called as a tight side. Okay. But if your drum will be rotated in the anti-clockwise direction, that is called as a tight side, and this is called as a slack side. Okay. Now we can consider here T1 and T2, that is called as a tight side in the tight side and slack side. R1 and R2 is the radius of the pulley, velocity. We know that what is the velocity of the bale. So now the work done per minute, that is what work done per second, that is called as a T1 by T2 into V. That is called as a velocity. And the power transmission, P equal to T1 minus T2 into V, that is called as also power transmission. And little consider, we saw that torque equal to what? That is called as a force into distance. So T1 minus T2 into R1, and similarly the extent T1 minus T2 into the R2. So that is called as a power transmission. Okay, now ratio of the driving tension for the belt drive, and that is called as a 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Okay, that is the simple logic for the power transmission. Now, how can we calculate the power transmission for the one pulley to the another pulley? That is called as we can show here the one examples. Find the power transmission by the belt running over the pulley of 600 mm diameter. Okay, so that is called as a D, that is called 600 diameter, 0.6 meter at 200 RPM. Yeah, 200 RPM pe wo rotate ho raha hai. The coefficient of the frictions, that is called as a mu, is 0.25, and between the belt and drive pulley is 0.25. Angle of lap, that is called as a theta is a 160. Okay. And the maximum tension, that is called as a T1, that is called as a 500. So we can here the find the power. Power, that means what? Power will be considered here P equal to T1 minus T2 into V. Okay. But we, from this figure, we can RPM will be a given. Here the velocity ratio is pi dn by 16, we're getting the V. But T1 and T2, from this equation 2.3 log T1 by T2 mu theta, we can consider here from this equation T1 by T2 equal to 51, and T2 will be a here 176.47. Okay, so from this equation we can get the T2, T1 will be a given. So we can put here the P equal to T1 minus T2 into V and get the power. Okay, so basic equations for the transmitting the power is called as a 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta, and from the power, use power to the rise the casting, that is called a V equal to pi dn by 60, and power of the rise casting, that is called a P T1 by T2 equal to V, and from this equation we get the 2.27.5 kilonewton. Okay, so now that is the concern with the casting wing. This is the concern with the casting wing. Okay, another theory is concerned with the centrifugal tension in the bale. What is centrifugal? We know that, okay, it will be rotated in the circular direction. Okay, so in which since the bale is continuously runs over the pulley, and therefore some centrifugal forces causes. those effect in the increasing in the tension both right tide as well as in the sex tide. And this tension is causes color, this called as a centrifugal force is called as a centrifugal tension. Okay, so if your drum will be rotated in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, that time due to the centrifugal force, the tension will be a centrifugal force. It will be a tension will be a going in the slack side and tight side. That is called as a centrifugal tension. Okay, so that is the call as a centrifugal tension. In which, what is the initial tension? Initial tension, that means what? A belt is wood around the two pulley. Its two end are joined together. Okay, so that the belt may continuously move over a pulley, since the motions of the belt from driver and followers governed by the frame grip. Okay, due to the frictional between the belt and pulley, in order to increase this grip, this belt is tightened up. Okay, getting my point? At this stage, when the pulley are stationary and a belt is subject to the some tension, that is called as a tension stress. Okay, इसमें क्या हो रहा है? In tension of the belt, that means what? Okay, if the drum will be rotated continuously 2 hours, 3 hours, 5 hours, 4 hours, shaft will be passing power to be transmitted from driver pulley to the driven pulley continuously. But at the times of interval, the gripping of the belt, okay, driver pulley to the driven pulley, it will be a vary. Okay, so you can tightening the tension, that is called as the initial tension in the belt. Okay, so that is the most important criteria. What is the tightening? That is called as the initial tension. That is called as a T0. T1 is a tension in the tight side. T2 is equal tension in the slack side. And alpha is equal to the coefficient of the increasing of the belt. And from this equation, similarly in the we can calculate the tight side, slack side, also in the slack side tension, initial tension. And this equation T1 plus T2 equal to 2C/2. When the considering the centrifugal tension and neglecting, that is called as the T1/T2/2. Okay, whenever you design the belt, that time the initial tension will be you get the considering. That time the T1 plus T2 plus 2C/2, that is called as a considering the centrifugal tension. But if you are not considering the centrifugal tension, that is called as the initial tension T0 equal to T1 plus T2/2. Okay, so this is the simple manners for the belt drive. So it is this is the up to the this lecture is concerned with the only belt drive. In the next lecture we will consider rope and chain drive. But what will be a studies in this chapter, that what is the slip, what is the creep, and what is the initial tension and centrifugal tension in the belt according to your whenever you design a belt drive. Okay, thank you very much.